Hi, I'm Bex from MeasureSchool.com, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to set up your remarketing using Google Ads Remarketing Code and Google Tag Manager. Now, before we get started, there are three main components here that you need to be able to have access to and have available when setting up Google Ads Remarketing. First of all, you have to have your website that has to have Google Tag Manager already installed on it. You have to have your Google Tag Manager account, and you also have to have the Google Ads account that you're going to be using. So now let's get started, where I will show you how to set this all up. As you can see, I'm already in Google Ads, and I'm actually already in the area where we're going to set up the remarketing. For those of you who don't know, I came into my Google Ads account, I headed over to Tools and Settings, and then I clicked on Account Manager. Now, if you're setting up Google Ads remarketing for the first time, this is a screen that you'll be greeted with. So we want to come over to here to set up an audience source. Once we've clicked on that, we're now going to get this window. As you can see, there's lots of different sources you can use. And for the purpose of this video, we're going to use the Google Ads tag. So we're going to go over and hit Set Up Tag. And this is going to be step one of us basically creating our data source. As you can see, we have two methods here: general website visitors and collecting specific data on specific actions for people that have performed different things on the website to show personalized ads. For the purpose of this video, we're just going to click this one here. This is the very general and basic remarketing setup. Down here, we also have a restricted data processing checkbox. Now, unless you're going to be targeting the USA, there is probably no need for you to check this box. However, this account will be used to target people in the USA and to ensure that we comply with data laws in California, I'm going to check this box here. This basically means, as it says here, that no users based in California will be added to your remarketing list. So if there's any chance that somebody might be in California, I highly recommend ticking this box. So now that we've ticked, set up this step one, let's head over to Save and Continue. Now this part here is asking us to install the tag on our website. As you can see here, there are three different options. But as I mentioned at the start of this video, we're going to be using Google Tag Manager. So I'm going to come over here and click Google Tag Manager. As you can see, there's some detailed instructions. But the main thing that we want here is we're going to grab this conversion ID. I'm just going to Control C. And now that I've grabbed that, I'm going to head over to Google Tag Manager and we're going to get started there setting up remarketing within Google Tag Manager. So now we're here in our Google Tag Manager container for our demo shop. And if we come into the overview here, you can see it allows you to create a new tag. You can also create the tag directly in the window that we were just in by pressing New. Now we've got our window here to set up our tag configuration as well as our trigger. So first step is to come to our tag configuration. And as you can see on the right hand side, Google Tag Manager already has some pre-built tags. And obviously we're setting up Google Ads remarketing. And I have my conversion ID that I grabbed from the Google Ads account. So we're going to select this. And here it says here, your conversion ID. Now if we head back just to remind you, this is what we have here, our conversion ID. And as a best practice, I always like to set up my conversion ID as a variable. The reason for this and why it is best practice is a Google Ads conversion ID is unique to every Google Ads account. It never changes. So if you end up setting conversion tracking up later on, it does mean that you can just take this variable and pop it in here for any conversion tracking, and you don't have to keep going back to the Google Ads account. The only thing that is different every single time is the conversion label. So let's set up the variable so we have it there for future use. So I'm going to click on this little Lego brick, and it's going to take me over to the choose a variable. I want to head over to the top right and press the blue button. And the variable configuration, I just want to click. And now I want to scroll down to constant. And in here, I'm just going to control V that conversion ID. And I'm going to name it Google Ads Conversion ID. So it's really easy to find later on if we ever need to use it again. I'm going to click save. And because I saved it and I used this little Lego brick here to set it up, it's already inputted that for me. As I said, the conversion label is unique every time. For this, we don't need this. And we're actually not going to change any of these other settings here. And we're just going to head straight over to triggers. And for this, we're going to select all pages. So now we've set up our tag configuration and our triggers. Let's give this a name. And now we're going to hit save. So now we've set that up. Let's test to make sure that this actually works on our website. So we're going to put it into preview mode. And then we're going to head over to our demo shop and we're going to refresh. And here we have our Google Tag Manager preview mode. Now at this stage, nothing is live on our website. This is purely putting your browser into a special state to allow us to test the tags that we've just set up. And as you can see here, when I refreshed the window down here, we've got the Google Ads remarketing and it fired once. So we know now that we've set that up correctly. So let's head back over to the Google Tag Manager and let's hit submit. And this means we're now officially going to publish our container that we've just set up with the Google Ads remarketing code on it. And then that means it will be live on our website. So let's hit publish. There we go. And another good step to do just to make sure that everything is working correctly, once you're live, you can just refresh your page again and then head over to the Google Tag Assistant extension again, click it, and there you can see it. There is our Google Ads remarketing tag live on our website using the conversion ID, this number here, that matches what we have inside of Google Ads. Now that everything is set up on Google Tag Manager, we want to come back into Google Ads and head over to our audience list. And this is where we'll be able to create our first audience list. Click here, this blue button, and you want to select website visitors. You want to give it a name. So let's call this all visitors. We're going to leave this at visitors of all pages. And match any rule. Page URL contains. So we're going to take our root domain and we're going to put it in here. And we're going to remove everything around it. So we just have the URL as it stands there. And you can select here pre-fill options. You can start with an empty list or pre-fill from the last 30 days. I always just like to leave it on this standard. Your membership duration. This basically means how long do you want someone to stay in the list? You can have it up to a maximum of 540 days, but let's put this list to 90. And actually, let's improve our naming convention as well. So we're going to have this called All Day, All Visitors, 90 Days. You can obviously change this and your membership duration to whatever best suits you. Once we've done that, just hit Create Audience, and there we have it. We have our all visitors, 90 days all set up, and it's going to start populating here. You're going to probably have to wait anywhere between 24 to 48 hours for these figures to appear. So now that your remarketing is all set up directly in Google Ads with the help of Google Tag Manager, you can now go ahead and start creating your Google Ads remarketing campaigns.
All right, did you enjoy this video? Then let us know in the comments down below. And if you also have any questions, put them down there. And you haven't yet? Well, you should. Subscribe to our channel right over there because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.